Hi, let's talk a little bit about the Stamitz Viola Concerto in D major. And we'll start with the first movement. I'm going to do this video over several parts, over several days or even weeks. So right now I'm going to just play the very beginning and talk about that, how I practice it, my feelings about it. And then every few days I'll make another video that will add to that until we get through with the whole piece. So I'll do movements one first and then movement two first and then movement three. So we'll get through the whole Stamitz Viola Concerto. In this first video, I probably won't get too far, but we'll talk about a few things about the piece. First of all, Stamitz is from the Mannheim school. He wrote music in the 1700s. His music is awesome. He was kind of a contemporary of Mozart. And we all love this piece. It's a major piece in the repertoire for the viola. So let's get right into it and talk about how it works. Well, the beginning to me is three plateaus. So I want to start on the low plateau, move to the second, and then get to the third. What's important to me here, when I play the chords, I want my instrument ringing, I want to sound beautiful, and I want things to be nice and open and pleasant to listen to. So at the beginning, I make sure I'm really in tune with that fourth between the A and the D, and try to get my instrument to really ring, like so. So that means I'm going to be using a lot of my arm and not as much of my elbow, but really swinging my arm to get the instrument to make a nice open ringy sound. Since that's the bottom of the plateau, the lowest plateau, I'm going to be using about half of a bow and making sure that my second note, the D, has a good attach, bite, release, and ring. Ringing. The second plateau is a little bit more, so I'm going to use about 3/4 of the bow and open up my arm just a little bit more. Now you'll notice here that I'm going to vibrate almost every note. That's an important thing to me. So the more notes we vibrate, the more open and ringing we can get our viola. So now we have two plateaus. Now we get to the third and highest plateau. So we really want to make a lot of sound, but keeping it open and warm and beautiful and vibrant. Like so. Make sure at the end that you don't lose too much sound so we don't hear you, because we have to hear the viola resolve. So make sure when we play the F sharp, you have plenty of bow left and enough bow pressure. Like so, and nice and vibrant. So the very beginning sounds like this. When we get to the thirds coming up, they're very tricky. It's hard to play that in tune. It's hard to find a good fingering. It's awkward. You need to vibrate it. So I'm going to give you two suggestions of fingerings, and you can do whatever you like. Try both. See what works best for you. The first fingering I use is 1-3, 1-3, 2-4. Like so. This is a little hard to vibrate when you do 2 and 4. It takes a lot of work. So another one we can use is 1-3, 1-3, 1-3. So. So that's a good one. 1-3, 1-3, 1-3. So we can just kind of 1-3 here. The first finger moves up and then together like that. And then we can vibrate over there. The other looks like this. The 2 and the 4 still has to vibrate. It's a little harder to vibrate there, but it can be done, so we practice both ways. So I'm going to use the 1-3, 1-3, 1-3 fingering and show you what that looks like there. Now when I do those strokes here, I always lean the bow a little bit forward. In other words, the tip's going to point that way, away from me. So I don't want the bow to look like this. Rather, I want the bow to look like this. So my arm has to come back here and I leave my bow pointing forward. So it's not quite straight. Straight looks like this. I'm gonna look like this. That way the bow can bite the string just a little bit better. So, like that. When I get to the C string, I use a little bit more pressure so that I get that nice depth in my C string. So that'll sound. The next section is very tricky because of the octaves at the end of it, and we have to be very careful to try to have our octaves just as in tune as we can. It's hard to do, so we need to practice that a lot. And when we get to the end there, I'm always praying that I'm successful in the octaves, and you never know what's gonna come out, but if we practice enough, probably they will be okay. So let's talk about the first part. There's a really nice bass line here, which goes. Something like that. So when we hear that, I try to show that. So not all the notes are created equally. Some of them need a little bit more. So you'll hear when I'm playing that you'll hear this bass line kind of popping out while the other notes are kind of over here. The bass line's kind of in its own little place. Something like this. So you hear that every one of those bass line notes is popping out, and it shows basically the melody and what I want people to hear. So that's very important. Then we get to the octaves. Before I even play fast, I'm going to play it a little bit on the slow side. I make sure my fingers stay down as much as possible. My left hand needs to be very relaxed. Like so. Whenever I get to the top, I always hold my fingers down like this. I have two checks I can make. The first is the G string to make sure that's in tune. So it's basically a fifth. It sounds almost like an octave to me. Like if you play it really nicely in tune, it almost sounds like those notes belong together. And then I have an octave on the top. Very easy to play sharp. I remember what I did there, then I'm gonna try to do it again. Very hard. So you can see I need a little bit of practice on there, and probably I'll do that later. But right now I'm gonna try to put those two parts together and see what I come up with. Remember, when I finish, I'm gonna hold my octave down like that so I can check it. Like that. So I'm just a little bit sharp still. I'm thinking about that. I'm gonna try it again. A little bit better. So there you have it, right there. Now I'm gonna hold my hand there and then play on. So I can just put my second finger down. It's right there, loose vibrato, like so. So now I have a nice loose and easy sound. So that whole passage will sound. Tell you have no idea how nerve-wracking it is to play that on a video like this. It's kind of funny. It's hard to play. I mean, it's hard for everybody. So it takes a lot of work. There's no substitute for that slow practice. like that. It's very, very, very hard to do. So the next part, I use a lot of bow distribution. I love the fifth, the open sound, like that. A little vibrato. We don't want too much. It tends to distort the sound. So just enough vibrato to get our sound ringing. Well, I guess that's enough for the video today. That's the beginning of the Stamitz, and I'll play it through for you one time and hope you enjoyed the video. And remember, check back in just a few days and I'll continue with that first movement. Until then, happy practicing!